Hey, what's up, people? Michael here. If you want to partner your YouTube channel up, check out the link in the description. Thank you and stay tuned for the video coming up. Long awaited and very anticipated. Mike here, bringing you episode 2 of The Walking Dead. Now, this is not Survival Instinct. I know I took a little break or whatever, but this is Telltale Games' version of The Walking Dead. This one came out prior to Survival Instinct. Now, I did do that entire walkthrough for that game, if anybody wants to check that out, but as you can see, I did put up episode 1, dang, back in January. I did not plan to take that long. Let's just go ahead and jump into episode 2 and keep it moving. So this one's called Starved for Help. And yeah, a lot of people like episode 1, so hopefully I can make you like episode 2 again. But yeah, compared to Survival Instinct, this is a way better game. Survival Instinct was obviously just a cash-in, but you can still have fun with that game, to be honest. It's not as bad as everybody's making it out to be. There's some fun to be found in there, definitely. But anyway, that's yesterday's news, just like the Ravens winning the Super Bowl. So we are on to newer and better things, which is episode 2 of this Telltale Games Walking Dead.
Previously on The Walking Dead.
I know who you are.
I got
Watch
another
out!
Good one for you.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly, you'll shift in with Doug.
You got it, boss.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
We reason with him.
The bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
Yeah, I remember that part.
God.
And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
Yeah, so that's pretty awesome. It shows you exactly every decision you made in episode 1. So that previously on, that's totally catered to your decisions based off, well, there you go. They just said it for me. But yeah, you know, we got a black main character. We got a black narrator. What could be better than episode 2 with yours truly, Michael? But it's, you know, I think what really everybody likes about this game is the presentation. 3 months later, awesome. So we got a little time skip going on. And anybody who's not too familiar with this version of the game, you don't really have to do too much.
What'd they get this time?
Looks like a rabbit.
Compared to Survival Instinct.
Another meal lost. I still can't believe we went through all that commissary food in 3 months. It seemed like so much at the time.
Maybe you shouldn't have opened the door.
Yeah, except then I'd probably be food by now. Trust me, I have no regrets.
Yeah, rabbit's hardly a meal, Mark, but I'd take it. We're all hungry.
No kidding. When I accidentally grabbed for Carly's rations the other night, I thought she was gonna take off my hand.
We're all on edge. Just cut us some slack.
Yeah, you're right. I wish I knew for sure how much food we have left.
We'll manage.
Maybe. You know, some people aren't too happy about the way Lily's handling rations.
Lily knows it's important to keep the adults fed and functioning. Sometimes that means someone's gotta miss a meal.
You think Kenny's having any more luck than we are out here?
I sure hope so.
So I completely forgot, you know, who most of these characters are. That's what happens when you take a 3-month break in between episodes.
You know, Kenny's been talking about taking off if he can get that RV running.
I don't know who Kenny is, so...
He's got a wife and son to look out for.
And they're safest in a big group. Going out on his own will get them all killed. Can't blame him, though. Did you hear Larry going off on him last night? What's the old guy's deal, anyway? Seems like he's got a problem with you in particular.
He's an old racist asshole.
He knows what Larry's problem is.
Maybe that's just the way he is, but that guy needs to chill out. And I know Lily thinks he's getting weaker, but the guy's all muscle. He's a walking pile driver. I know I wouldn't want to be stuck in a room with him. And didn't he punch you in the face one time?
Knock me flat.
So, anybody who's not familiar with episode one, I think the way it is I'm an escaped convict. Haha, yeah, make all the jokes you want. Anyway, I'm an escaped convict, I believe. And only a certain number of people know that.
Don't. Gunshot will bring walkers. Bird's not worth it.
Yeah, I know. I'm just really freaking hungry.
But anyway, yeah, so only a certain people know my history. So I guess not the whole crew in camp knows yet. So, you know what I mean? You gotta play it cool.
Come on.
And it's fine. I was going on here now. But yeah, if he would have shot over a bird, I would have been highly upset. That would have been stupid. Ah, damn.
Jesus Christ.
How'd that happen?
Oh, shit. No, no. Please don't kill us. We just want to help our teacher. We'll leave, I swear.
Lee, you guys okay?
Get it off. Get it off. God damn it. Get it off me.
Travis, maybe they can help.
These might be the same guys that raided our camp, and we barely got away from that.
What guys? Why the fuck is there a bear trap out here?
It's okay. We're not gonna hurt you.
Don't listen to them, Ben. Please, just let us go. We're not a threat to you.
Kid, chill out. We'll try to help you, but you gotta shut the fuck up.
This is fucked up. We've gotta help. Please.
Ben, shut up. My dad was special forces. I know what I'm doing.
Just see if you can get him out. After that, you can leave us or whatever. I don't care. Please.
We gotta get him out of there.
Oh, God.
Man, I barely had time to think on that
one. Fine, but you gotta hurry.
All right, so let's do it.
Hurry,
oh, here come the walkers.
Lee, this trap's been altered. There's no release latch.
Gotta get out of there.
Oh, no.
Shit, walkers. It's now or never, Lee.
Please.
Screw that. Yeah, he's on his own.
Get the boys back.
Oh, my
Jamie,
hero.
Keep those walkers off of me.
Why don't you use the axe?
He's lost so much blood already! Please, hurry up!
Stop, stop, stop!
Lee, do something!
Alright, we're cutting your leg, bro.
Go. I'm gonna have to cut you out.
No, no, no!
Try to cut the chain!
Try the trap again! Anything, please!
I mean, no, let's man, go, I gotta cut your leg. There's nothing else I could do. Oh, man.
Oh, it
man.
Has to be now.
Oh, could you imagine having to do that to somebody, man? That is just nasty.
Damn it, Lee, just cut off his fucking leg.
That is easy as it sounds, man. I'm this sorry. Guy isn't raiding over here. Now you gotta cover him and whatnot. He threw up.
Alive, grab him and let's go.
It's kind of like what we had to do to Herschel. Oh, I'm sorry.
Behind you,
Travis.
Oh, of course. On, of course, it will be him. Of course, he can still get away. What the hell? Of course, of course, of course, Travis. Like Kevin Hart said, somebody had to go. Oh, cool. I got an achievement. Oh yeah, we are at the motel. It's crazy what happened last time. Times are hard. People are on our edge. Food is low. There's nothing to do. As a little girl plays soccer by herself. Boy has to do his homework, and the principal watches them over. Cause she knows if she stops kicking that ball, that is the end of her recess. The love interest of father and daughter is secret, but well known within the community. Who watches in the forest? Ninjas. Zombie ninjas. You can't shoot a zombie ninja.
Get the gates open! We've got wounded!
Shit! What the hell are they doing?
Come on, come on!
Oh my God! What happened?
Oh,
what
the hell?
What's going on?
I don't have time to explain.
Lee, are you okay?
Get him into the truck. I'll see what I can do.
Kat, okay? Can you fix him?
Jesus, Ken!
Lee!
I don't know!
Lee! What the hell? You can't just be bringing new people here. What are you thinking?
Hey, you want to calm down for a fucking minute?
What? No, I don't! I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
He would have died if we left him.
So what?
We are not responsible for every struggling survivor we come across. We have to focus on our group, right here, right now.
Well, hang on. We haven't even talked to these people yet. Maybe they can be
helpful. Yeah, there you go.
Come on, Lily. These are people. People trying to survive just like us. We've got to stick together to survive.
The only reason you're here is because you had food. Enough for all of us. But that food is almost gone. We've got maybe a week's worth left. And I don't suppose you guys are carrying any groceries, are you?
No.
Fine, you guys fight it out then. Welcome to the family, kid.
Come over here and see what I drew.
What? No, I...
Just come on, okay?
You know, you like to think you're the leader of this little group, but we can make our own goddamn decisions. This isn't your own personal dictatorship.
Oh, come on, you're being dramatic. Everything always turns into a power struggle between you two. I'm not gonna be a part of that.
Hey, I didn't ask to lead this group. Everyone was happy to have me distributing the food when there was enough to go around.
It doesn't matter who's in charge.
Now that it's running out, suddenly I'm a goddamn Nazi.
It doesn't matter who's in charge. Most people are here now. I guess we just have to decide what happens next.
No, Lee, it does matter. One person can't be in charge of everything. You know, it might feel safe for you to sit on the fence. But sooner or later, you're gonna have to decide whose side you're on.
It's like every choice you make, there's a good and a bad.
I don't see any of you stepping up to make the hard decisions. My girl's got more balls than all of you combined.
Dad, please. Why don't you go help Mark with the wall?
So, I don't know if it's just me or maybe because I got the disc version, but it's kind of like the game can't keep up with
Everyone's
the loading.
Everyone's starting to hate me because I'm the one that rations the food, but nobody else wants to. You know what? I'm not doing it tonight. You do it. There's today's food rations, but there's not enough for everyone. Good luck.
Everybody need to get their panties out the bunch. You have enough 4 food items to feed 10 hungry people. Damn, son, we got crackers and cheese. Times is hard. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I don't know how many people we got, but hopefully it's less than 10. If not, I know who's not getting any crackers and cheese. Yeah, that guy. So now, as we make our way towards the abandoned hotel, we have this woman who I can't pronounce.
Here, eat something.
Why don't you give it to Doc? I'm a little busy with your mess right now.
Is he gonna be okay?
I don't know. Can you give me a hand real quick?
Sure. What do you need?
Just apply some pressure here while I try to close this up. You know, I thought I was starting to get used to this, sewing up people's injuries. But I mean, cuts and bruises are one thing, but Lee, this man has no leg.
I did the right thing.
Yeah, I know you did. The right thing is just scary sometimes, I guess. Well, you've done all you can, Lee. Thanks for the help. Go ahead and check in on the others. I need a little
space. So many haters. Haters everywhere I go. Why they hating so much, man? I'm just a brother out here trying to live. Trying to, you know, make the best of Travelier Motel.
Will you hold the damn board steady?
I'm trying. I didn't realize I was getting this weak already.
What do you want? A handout? Oh, I got 60 cents in my pocket, if you'll shut up and quit being such a pansy.
Yeah, he's definitely not getting any crackers and cheese. No crackers and cheese for that guy.
It keeps the walkers out. Carly's been doing the bulk of the lookout duty.
Let's see what's going on with this.
Hey, you holding up okay, Lee? I was pretty fucked up back there, having to cut that guy's leg off.
Yeah, I just hope Katja can save him. Lily's pretty pissed at us.
Listen, I know her intentions are good, but...
But nothing! She's making the smart choice. Those parasites you guys brought back need to go.
So I'm going to give this guy some crackers and cheese because I already know he was weak. And he deserves it.
Here, eat something.
Oh, wow. We got half an apple. Oh, we got a lot of things more than crackers and cheese. All right. Give your ass some jerky.
Thanks, Lee.
Need any help with the wall?
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. Do you mind if we take it?
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Huh. Definitely giving it to Mark.
Here, Mark, this should help.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm the one doing all the work over here. You didn't think to give me the axe?
Come on, Larry. What is it between you two? Why do you have a personal grudge against Lee?
He knows why.
Shame, shame, shame.
You've got to talk to Lily about getting along with Kenny.
Lily can make her own friends.
It's not about making friends. We're all in this together. We gotta start acting like it.
Stuff all that. We'd be fine without you.
See, he's just a sourpuss, you know what I mean?
Lily thinks we should throw these new people out.
Damn right. There's too many people hanging around here as it is.
Keep up on that fence.
Don't tell me what to do.
See, he don't... Well, actually, he could let out my secret, so... Maybe I should just give him some food. Maybe he'll be kind of happy or whatever, so...
Here, Larry.
Even though we don't want to... I can maybe give him half an apple.
I hope you don't think this makes us friends.
I could have gave you nothing.
I did make a tough choice. Because I could have kept that damn apple.
At least the kids have something to keep them occupied.
Oh yeah, that's totally fun.
How you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
Now we got to find hats. Upon everything else. Now we can give her some food. Well, obviously the kids need food. The new guy, I don't really care too much about. We can see what's good with him. We can talk to him, but he hasn't deserved his food yet.
Hey, is my friend gonna make it?
I don't know, but Katja will do her best. I promise.
I can't believe you chopped off his leg.
There was no other way. How you holding up, kid?
Well, I, I keep wondering if I could have done something to help, you know? Some kind of... I don't know. Something.
You'll be prepared next time.
Next time? Yeah.
So who are you people? Our group's gonna wanna know.
I'm Ben. Ben Paul. The man you saved is Mr.
Two
Parker.
First names.
The band director at my school. We all came down from Stone Mountain for the playoffs when everything happened.
Relax. We'll get your friend back to normal in no time.
I sure hope so.
Keep it moving. Keep it moving. Let's see what we get with Duck Duck.
How you doing, Duck?
I'm okay. Me and Clementine are coloring.
Guess what it is?
I don't know. A dog?
Nope.
Oh, I know. It's a goat, right?
No.
You were pretty brave when we brought those people in here.
That's because I know Mom can fix him.
Catch you later, Duck.
You don't sound too hungry. Maybe we can skip the kids. I'm not sure how much crackers and cheese I have left.
Sleeping any better?
No. I know we should be grateful for beds, but no, I'm not.
Drugstore?
Yeah.
Lily has me handing out the food.
Ugh, that can't be an easy job.
It's not. I won't be able to feed everyone. What should I do?
Well, if you wanted to get in good with Lily, I'd make sure Larry gets some food, even though that guy can be a real dick sometimes. On the other hand, giving that food to Kenny and his family might make him remember you, if he decides to take off in that RV one day.
What about you? You need food too.
We all need food. I can't tell you what to do, but whatever happens, I know you'll be trying to do the right thing.
Thanks, Carly.
She's understanding, so she can go hungry.
Back in a bit.
Definitely want to give son to this dude, because he's always conflicted. I didn't make his wife randomly repair some guy she don't even know.
Word's getting out that you want to leave the motor in.
That ain't no secret, Lee. It's probably our best bet.
I'm not sure that's the best idea.
You gave Glenn your blessing when he left. Just asking you respect my choice as well.
Yeah, but he was leaving to find his friends. Your family's right here.
Well, here isn't doing us any good. You should think about coming with us, you and Clem.
I'm conflicted. I don't know. That would be less mouths to feed and we don't have to worry about all these other people, but we got a pretty safe fort going on here.
We need you here. We have a better chance of surviving as a group.
Our best chance of surviving is to get away from the mainland. My mind is made up.
Well then, take some food, buddy.
Want something to eat? Here, Kenny. Take this.
How about my boy? He eat yet?
No.
Come talk to me once my boy's taken care of.
Jeez, so picky. So freaking picky. So I got two pieces of food. I gotta feed your boy and you? I don't think so. I think you'll be happy that I fed your child.
Hey, Doc. How about a little food?
Oh, boy. He looking like he hasn't eaten in days. Look at this kid. Gonna be the best crackers and cheese he ever had.
Here.
Yeah. Oh, man, I'm so hungry.
Some of these people have gone longer than me without food. They're the ones that need it.
No, it's either... It's gotta be the children. Like, that would make the most reasonable stuff. Even for you, but I could talk to you at least.
We should talk about you and Kenny.
What about us?
They're arguing. It's getting pretty out of hand. You know people notice that.
Look, I'm working my ass off to make sure we have a good setup here, and Kenny just doesn't appreciate that. All we need is food.
But there is no food. You know that better than anyone.
Well, we'll just have to find some.
Maybe we should think about leaving the motel.
God, not you too. I know Kenny wants to leave. I think that's why he's so eager to get the RV working. But this is a good spot. We're protected. We're close to the drugstore. We have a routine now, and it's working.
For now. Keep an eye out.
Fine.
Yeah, I'll just give her the food. It makes the most sense.
Here, Clem. You need something to eat.
Okay. A Sunday would be better next time.
She always complaining.
Keep that in mind.
Who was this child's parent? Episode 1. She was too good for whatever the hell we've given her, the energy bars. Now she's still too good for the crackers and cheese.
Not such an easy job, is it? It's okay. I know you're still watching out for me.
I don't envy you. I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
Lee.
Kenny, I know I ran out of food before.
Hey, it was a tough choice, but you took care of the kids. That's what a real man does.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm serious about that offer to come with us. You've more than earned a ride on the RV with me. Still, I guess some people aren't going to be happy with your choices.
See, you can still be a nice guy, a good guy, and kind of win over everybody slowly, but that's tough, you know, being a leader. Can't make everybody happy.
He didn't make it, did he?
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing...
What the hell is his problem?
He just needs time. It's been a rough morning.
That man you brought, I tried, but he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
What about the other kid?
Oh. What the heck?
The axe! Hurry!
Oh. Oh man, so many bad choices. Too many bad choices. Are you serious? I should have never gave it to him because he's weak. Too many bad choices. Oh man, this is getting real. Oh snap. Really? Really?
Shoot it!
Damn. Alright.
You okay?
Triple N's. No new friends. If you know the real definition, you know exactly what word I was trying to say. Chief keeping them would say it.
All killed. Why didn't you tell us he was bitten?
What?
He was bitten, and you didn't say a goddamn word.
But he wasn't bitten, I swear.
Well, your not bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife.
What?
Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it. You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us.
God help us.
It makes sense. In those first few days, it spread so fast.
Car accidents, suicides, everything was making more of them.
When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym and everybody thought we were finally safe. But one of the girls, Jenny Pitcher, I think, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills. A lot of them. Someone went in the girls' room the next morning and... God.
Back off!
Whoa, lady, relax. Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off!
Carly.
Are you armed?
Yeah. For protection. Dead could be anywhere.
But, I think you got the upper hand here.
Why do you need gas?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
Another tough decision. To trust these people?
Lee, why don't you and Mark check the
place out? Or not trust these people?
I'm going with you. I got your back if anything seems fishy.
So, what are y'all thinking?
Yeah, we might as well just go. I'm pretty sure we're going to lose somebody, but...
We'll bring some gas to your dairy.
What?
In exchange, you give us some food to
bring
back.
Nah, everyone shouldn't go.
See how it goes
from there. I ain't decide that.
Sounds fair.
That's a dumb idea.
Gallon should power one of our generators for a while.
Ah, here we go.
So, this dairy, you guys really have food?
Sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
It's nice to get away from that motel for a while. This Lily Kenny thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
You think they'd want me for a leader?
Sure. Everybody looks up to you.
Well, not everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
Because of your past. Does anyone else know?
Larry knows.
Great. That can't be easy.
Clementine might know. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore and asked me about it. I lied to her, but...
What exactly did happen with the senator?
Now is not the time.
Well, I'm here whenever you want to talk.
Never.
I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Not sure everyone would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
I move around a lot. Hard to call any place on.
All these questions already, you
know
what I mean?
I used to move around a bit myself, but the dairy will always be home to me.
Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
Uh-oh.
I am. You guys have any questions? You come to me.
Yeah.
How many people you got over there anyway?
Yeah, let's change the subject.
Well, the kid here is our newest arrival, but we're all looking forward to some food. We really need it.
Well, here's to helping each other out. Well,
I just don't trust these guys.
All out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for as long as I can remember, but now it's...
You think you're going to cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always
fucking
pulling this
bandits.
Who?
Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they? Fuck you. You knew we were hungry, and you guys were keeping it
off
yourself.
There's only two of them.
Oh, no, there's
a lot
more.
Yeah, you know what? We ate it all. What are you going to fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens. But let's just wait this out and hope they move on.
Fuck you!
Oh, wow.
Fuck you! Fuck you!
Jesus!
Wow.
Asshole.
The world out here has gone to shit. Come on. Let's get to the dairy.
That's crazy. It makes you really wonder, you know what I mean? If you had to make these decisions in real life, what would you be doing, you know? How do you trust? I don't trust people nowadays, so, you know what I mean? That would just be really bad for me. Can't trust these people out here, man. Everybody's so different. What a long walk.
Here it is, St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
That's the only bad thing about fuel. Dependent inventions, I guess. Eventually, that fuel will run out unless you find some Non-renewable energy source.
We're gonna assume that your friend here,
I think that's the term I needed.
Lee is silently impressed.
This place looks untouched. You'd never know the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He moves around a lot, but things the way they are, maybe we can convince him to stick around for a while.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh my goodness, that place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
I've got things under control over there.
Well, I hope you know what you're doing. That place isn't safe like it is here. Now that y'all are here, we'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
Does that offer apply to the rest of us?
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she...
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh my! Our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come for the day.
Well, how about this?
He like, man, if
y'all
you don't stop talking.
Your veterinary friend, and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'd be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence? Oh man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
Before we can think about bringing our whole group here to stay, we need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Right. Obviously they think it's safe. But is it safe enough for the kids? I noticed a broken swing over there. Not a big deal, but maybe there's other things not working that we just can't see yet.
And checking the fence perimeter sounds like a decent way to get a good look at their defenses.
All right, I'll keep my eyes open, and you find out what you can from Andy.
That's how you gotta do it. So, we are on a dairy farm. Let's see what's up with this swing. Maybe we can repair it or something.
Too bad it's broken. I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I'll bet. Mind if I fix it?
Sure, that'd be great. Mama sure does appreciate y'all helping out.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the seat and some rope. Make it safe for Clem and Duck. And let the St. Johns know we can pull our weight around here.
Yeah. So I assume we're gonna have to find those supplies. Either way, not a big issue.
So what have you found out? Is this looking like a good place to stay?
I'll keep looking around.
All right, keep me posted.
Well, some job he's doing, if all he's doing is just standing there.
Pointy. This is too big right now, but if I can find something to cut it down to size, this might make a good seat for the swing.
And voila. What are the odds we have a saw?
Mind if I use one of these boards?
Already making some repairs, huh? I like a guy who takes some initiative. Yeah, go right ahead.
Because pockets, when the world end, are as huge as boards. You got a generator? Let's take a look at that, I suppose.
What's that?
Generator. You guys come along with gas just in time. Hey, don't mess with that, okay? The thing's a little tricky, and I don't want to spend half a day trying to fix it again. Hi.
Hi.
Well, I'm glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back at the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. Been stockpiling, huh?
Yeah, no bull. Too many questions about us.
We've scraped together a good supply in the last few months. How about yourselves? What kind of protection do you have around here?
We collected a few guns to protect ourselves, but we really only use them when we go off the property. When we're inside the perimeter, the fence is all we need to keep us safe.
We can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks, trading for gas and food, but ultimately they moved on, looking for the people they lost contact with.
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them? That's good. The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman, he figured out how to amp it up with the generators. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzle and pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots, and we gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick. Like us.
Mark and I can help you with that perimeter now.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but gets overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
Cool. So, it's not looking as hostile as I thought it would be. You know, the dairy's looking pretty safe. These people are looking pretty straightforward. But of course, that's just the outside, you know, the perimeter as we're checking right now. So gotta look deep down inside their souls.
It's pretty amazing what they've done with this dairy, but let's see what it takes to secure this fence before drawing any conclusions.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
He wouldn't be such a pain in the ass if you weren't telling him we were talking behind his back all the time.
I'm sorry, all right?
I try to be civil at least.
He's too busy being cranky to notice.
So this guy's pretty much a snitch.
There's one.
Yeah, I don't like him.
Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off.
Andy said when this fence is working, the walkers go up like a tree branch on a power line. If those lights are out, that means the fence is off, right?
It better be.
It might still be alive.
Maybe the St. John boys are using this guy for target practice?
Poor guy.
I don't know what got him first, the arrow or the fence. Either way, hope he was already dead.
Alrighty. Well, we could take the arrow, at least.
Disgusting.
And you go.
Who do you think he was?
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't. It really doesn't.
Come on. I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God.
This guy's just way too excited. Walkers anymore?
Yeah, well, it's useless without gas.
We might need food, but the St. Johns need gas, too.
Not many drivers these days, Lee. We could scrounge up a year's worth of gas, easy.
So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. They seem decent enough. I just want you to know that I've got your back if anything goes down. That's all.
Thanks. There's another one.
I see it.
I just can't trust this guy for some reason. The fact that he goes off telling that we talk about the other person behind his back, so obviously he can't be trusted too well. I'm pretty sure there's going to be one that's still alive. I'm just waiting for it.
The fence burnt right into its hands. I think they fused together.
Hi, y'all. Chaw.
You never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Thanks for the rations earlier. It's not easy eating in front of the kids, but it's all that's keeping me on my feet right now.
I'm hungry too, Mark.
Do you think they're gonna be good for it? Dinner for a whole group of people?
If they've got as much food as they say, I think so.
Come on, I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place.
And this will be the one that's still alive or something.
I think we get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea.
Yeah, I'm not trusting this at all. At all.
Little help here, Lee? If you're waiting for that guy to help, it ain't gonna happen. Come on.
All right, man. It's on you. Parental discretion advised.
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on.
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
Oh, what the fuck?
What the? Get to the gate! Get down!
What is going on?
Jesus!
We had an agreement! Now you're fucked!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With the fence on, that gate is our only way out!
Then we gotta really figure this out.
Who the fuck are you?
Alright. Let's see what else we can do around here.
The blades are stuck in the dirt. The gate. We can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah! Give us shit! Get
closer! Oh man, this is wild. That guy's not really protected, but I can't believe they shot him. These must be the bandits. They gotta be. But obviously something went wrong, and we're gonna learn pretty shortly.
Shit. It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. We're gonna have to move.
What about our arrangement?
Move it, Hal.
Now we're gonna take what's on.
How do I move it?
We have to breathe. Now you're fucked.
And we're rolling.
Where do you think you're going?
Rolling like a tractor. Oh gosh, another one. They just all happen to be in our way.
Another one? How many of those things did we push down?
Oh, definitely not this one. If I remember correctly, we chopped off some hands and just pushed one off. Not in the middle of the freaking... Oh, great. Oh, great. You gotta curb stomp them. Gears of War style. I thought that he's still not dead after that.
Yeah, barely.
Come on, you
Oh, wow. I didn't even notice he was right behind me. Am I supposed to attack him or something? Please, explain. Oh, nice.
Let's get out of here.
How many arrows do they possibly really have?
You lucky sons of bitches! Go ahead and run! We ain't going nowhere!
We ain't going nowhere. That's a song I got coming out.
Lee, what's wrong?
The electric fence came on. Some people started attacking from the woods, and we got trapped between them and the fence.
Holy shit, are you okay?
I heard Mark yelling. Thought y'all were giving me the all clear. Man, I am real sorry.
Oh, my Lord! What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, Mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out, but God damn, it hurts.
Hey, y'all.
Mark! Oh my God, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just pull it out.
Oh no, honey, come on. Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well, you must be the veterinarian.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhands. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
God damn it. Carly said this place was locked down tight.
It was just a fluke thing. We can't stop assuming there aren't bad people out there.
What the hell do you mean a fluke?
It could have happened anywhere. Could have happened to us in the motor inn.
Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
It's wartime.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we eat.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits.
Say, Rambo.
You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Carly?
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor inn until we get back.
Hey, I remember seeing kids in your group, so I went ahead and fixed that swing while you were out. I hope your kids like swings.
A swing! I love swings! Just like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc.
Why don't you kids go and play on the swing, huh?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Those kids should be repopulating the earth. All right? Let's not fight the inevitable. They should be getting busy with the busy. Let's see how they doing. Oh, wow. Spare no time.
They look happy. Hey, Clem, do you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun.
Be sure to tell Andy thank you, okay?
I will. Will you push me on it?
Sure. Happy to push you on the swing. Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
Why he looks so mad? It was nothing but hate in his face all over. He's like, I know I'm not getting off this swing for no girl.
How you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
Get lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
Well, we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Be careful. I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
What a sweet, sweet guy. This is a great relationship these two have, you know? It's like the father she always wanted.
What do you think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were?
I'm not sure, Clem. I hope so.
I hope so, too.
Don't we all hope? Because without hope,
we're safe here.
What do you have?
As long as the bad people don't get me too, right?
I won't let what happened to Mark happen to you.
Promise?
I promise. All right, Clem, that's enough for now.
Okay, thanks for pushing me.
Of course, it's all yours.
Yeah!
Okay, Duck, don't pop a gasket.
Popping gaskets everywhere we go. Whoa. Right, who am I talking to here? Let's talk to Kenny.
Hey.
Haley, found anything interesting?
I was talking to Andy a bit earlier. Doesn't sound like they have too many guns around. They rely mostly on the fence to keep them safe.
So long as you're on this side, things are all right. Provided the fence holds out.
Well, that's the problem. When there's no more gas, there's no more fence.
That's true. Well, it's good to know what we're working with here. Keep looking around, and let me know if you find anything else.
How you holding up?
I hope they feed us, Lee. Soon. On the way over here, I was getting dizzy. Hands shaking, cold sweats. Thought I was gonna pass out.
They've got food here.
Yeah, but I'm not just talking about one meal, you know?
Did Duck and Katja get here okay?
No, it wasn't easy. Duck didn't look so good on the walk over to this place.
Well, if everything works out, maybe he and Katja can have an easier life here.
That's funny, considering you didn't seem too worried about Duck back at Herschel's farm.
That's in the past, Kenny. Lots happened since then.
Yeah, right.
He's all sour over old things, guess, like, come on, man.
About being here? How could that was the past. I give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch him go hungry. You're with me on this, right?
Yeah, of course. Lily's judgment is clouded, but you got a pretty clear head about these things. I'm gonna go have a look around.
Don't wait too long to help scope
so,
out that bandit.
So, even if I gotta lie.
A good opportunity to find out a bit more about the St. Johns and their relationship with those bandits or whatever.
Right. I'll see what I can find out.
So, even if I gotta lie to the guy or whoever I got him talking to, probably just gonna do it from now on. Because, although he may have a good point, just maybe say, we really don't know. I kinda see somebody possibly dying over here because of those bandits. In which case, Lily would be completely right about this.
How you feeling, Lee? Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know.
She getting real.
Work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So, are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Not now.
A few minutes. Just need to check on a few things before we head out.
Sure, that's understandable. Talk things over with your group. Just come find us when you're ready.
I'll do that.
So, obviously, you gotta wonder what else are they keeping from us, you know? That would have been some very vital information.
You can definitely tell they built this thing themselves.
That's why I'm trying to go to school for this electrician thing. Cause when shit gets real, I'm gonna be that master electrician that builds up an awesome fence made by solar power. Actually, that's not a bad idea. Don't steal my idea.
I guess Mark and I were lucky we weren't touching this thing when it came on.
Fences made from the sun, or powered by the sun, like Sunny Delight. I used to like Sunny Delight until I figured out it wasn't real orange juice. Man, and what's up with that taste it got? It's always so sour. Got this, like, no matter what you drink, you can always guarantee that sour taste. Like orange juice and 99% sour.
Enough of these might work as adequate cover from arrows, if that becomes a problem.
We got a barn. I guess we can see what's inside of there. I don't really see anything else around. Oh wait, just tons of things.
If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts. Looks like a feeding station for the cow.
A very observant player we have.
Having a crop like that on hand must be great. We're gonna need to learn how to maintain it if we end up staying here.
All that corn. I don't like corn.
Lee, oh my god, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
Hey, can I talk to you in private for a second?
Okay.
It's been 3 months. Your dad still treats me like I'm some kind of asshole.
Yeah, well, don't expect that to change. That's just how he is.
Does he treat you like that too?
Look, my dad can be an ass sometimes, I know that. But he's not a bad guy. He's got a lot of pain. He's been through so much, and lost pretty much everything. And it's hardened him, you know? Yeah, he's bitter and hateful, but that's all just to protect himself. And me. All he's got left in the world is me. And that goes both ways. So yeah, he's probably gonna keep treating you like crap, but that's just because he still has one thing left to care about. So don't judge him. And don't judge me for sticking by him. He's my dad. And I love him.
Very understandable. Can't be mad at that.
Take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything, but gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid if you ask me. Hey, thanks for backing me up this morning at the motel. I know I came down on you guys pretty hard, but you do agree with the way I'm running things, right?
Tell him anything.
Too emotional, but his intentions are in the right place. Still, it'd be best for all of us if you two could try to work together once in a while.
This is probably gonna bite me in the ass come later on. I'm playing to both of these two characters, okay. But it's whatever.
Think our little arrangement with them was a good idea?
A little late to be asking that now, don't you think?
Dad's right. Let's just wait for dinner, and then if Mark is feeling up to it, we leave. I don't want to push our luck here.
Now, let's not be hasty.
How do you feel about leaving the motor in?
It's a welcome change of scenery.
I don't know. If we'd just stayed where we were, then Mark wouldn't have ended up with an arrow in his shoulder.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Yeah. And we don't need you poking your nose where it don't belong and getting us thrown out in our asses.
See? That's why he didn't get no damn food. Actually, I had to because she would have felt some type of way. Otherwise, yeah, he wouldn't have got no food at all. He's just a constant asshole. Eventually, I hope he does die, get bitten or something. Let the opportunity come where I have to make that decision. Oh, it's going to be a sweet one. So I guess we could just go ahead and take care of these bandits all, you know, gang member style. Thugs.
Hey, Lee.
Change your mind about going out to track down them bandits?
Hells yeah. Let's do this.
It'll be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about what we're up against. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Of course.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Bitches.
Are you going now?
Yeah, I'll be back soon, Clementine.
Please be lucky.
I will.
That's hot. It's not even, you know, please be safe. Or, you know, anything of that matter. But I never really heard anybody say, you know, please be lucky. That's really hot, you know what I mean? In a different type of way. Start saying that. You know, please be lucky. Luck ain't got nothing to do with it, baby.
See anything?
Not yet.
He definitely should not be walking behind me, I know that much.
I know it's around here. It's gotta be close.
Here.
Oh shit, you found it?
Alright, this can only go one of two ways, good or bad.
You see anybody?
Can't tell.
Watch my back, Lee. I'm gonna check out the tent.
Might as well just take the fuel and take everything else that you need and get the hell out of there. What if there's a walker inside? You know, I wouldn't even fuck the tent. Ooh, that was close. That was close.
Clear. This camp's too small. It can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Let's make this quick.
Empty. But it looks like someone's been eating out of these. Recently.
What else we got?
Just water.
All these chicken noodle soup cans.
Yuck. I don't need that. Nothing. Empty.
Well, this is going well. What was the point of that?
Looks like they expected to be here a while. Tent looks pretty new. Anybody inside?
Two sleeping bags. One of them's kid-sized.
Looks like they were moving a lot of stuff.
Well, aren't we just the Sherlock Holmes of the times?
What's in the boxes?
They're all from Save Lots.
The first few days, they told folks to gather to the Save Lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking?
Not unless you need a bunch of empty cans.
I'll pass.
Boxes from the dairy here.
Probably the food we've been giving them. Fuckers cross the line.
Here we go. Starting to get some real shit. He shouldn't even say this stuff out loud at this point anymore. This is getting good.
What'd you find?
Nothing.
A video camera.
Of course, he told him.
Let me see that.
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good.
What else they got over here? Let's see if we can find anything useful and then get a move on.
See, he's coming. He's becoming a little hostile
now.
I see you
handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Lily? I thought you were running things back there.
Yeah, but she's got the combat training.
Oh, man. Things are getting quite good. Quite good indeed. And for the most part, I guess that is everything. See if he was lying about the tent. Got a photo, sleeping bag, and another sleeping bag.
Jesus, is that kid mixed up in this?
Was more like.
Oh man, don't do it. What's behind there? Oh, a hat.
The hell?
Don't fucking move!
Shit!
What the
Put
fuck?
Put your guns down. I ain't going back. You tell him Jolene ain't going back.
Aw, shit.
Hey,
she's getting real.
Deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are.
Is that Clementine's hat, though?
You don't know me.
Steal my shit. Steal everything from me.
We had a deal. You people broke it first.
Who the fuck are you? Look, it's not safe up here in the woods. You gotta come back to the dairy.
Oh, it's a hell of a lot safer up here than down there, you best believe. Now, maybe you didn't hear me last time when I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down. You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice sharp arrow right through your eyeball and into your goddamn brain. You're not men. You're monsters. All men are monsters. Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Where did you get this hat?
The little girl.
You stole it from her.
So what if I did? You stole her from me.
What the hell are you talking about?
You know what? I changed my mind. I'm putting this arrow right through your balls. Yeah, right through. String them up on that tree. Then I'm gonna head down to that farm and shoot every goddamn person I see.
Put down the crossbow.
No, sir, I need it. I need it to kill you fuckers.
It's getting real. Now I'm no crossbow, but
no,
I don't want to kill her if we don't have to.
Boy.
She's kind of crazy,
tell
but I don't
what
know.
You got in mind for-
Oh, who? What? What?
God damn it!
You straight up murdered that woman!
Hardly. She had a crossbow pointed at my forehead. It's a clean
and
shot.
That's
though.
The end of that chapter.
Right through the forehead. That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
So, that's it. We going back?
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them. So yeah, we head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message.
Wild, wild, wild. See, I was thinking that was Clementine's mother or something like that, but wow.
Come on.
Plot holes, plot holes. On top of plot holes. Murderers on top of murderers. And dead ladies who ain't be talking no more. This is The Walking Dead. Somebody just Twitter bombed me.
Man, that was a hell of a ride, huh?
Jesus, Danny.
What? You ain't getting soft on them, are you? Not after what they did to your friend.
You're back. What happened?
Handled it, Mama.
This isn't what Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Then screw it up for everybody then, why don't you?
Oh, calm down, Princess. I'll do it myself.
What's going on with them?
Dunno. Squabbling, looks like. A lot of tension with y'all, huh?
They have different ideas about how we should run our group. If they don't find any common ground, this whole thing's gonna fall apart.
No, it's just tough times. Everyone's hungry and people get a little stir-crazy when their tummy's empty. And Lee, don't worry your head about them bandits. I'm sorry you've seen more violence than I'd have thought in your short time, but you all are safe here. Don't worry.
I think I'll go have a look around.
Don't wander too far. Dinner will be ready before you know it. And thank your friend Koch again for me. She and the kids are in the barn with the cow. That woman is a lifesaver.
So now we gotta figure out the secret behind the hat and why she would give a hat to somebody she doesn't know. Or maybe she does know her. Da da dum. Time to pull off that belt and give it a little whooping. Like, girl, why tell you about this hat? Come here, girl. I know, daddy, no. It got dark fast.
It's okay, Clementine. You can pet her.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Whoa. Katya says Mabel could have her baby tonight.
We'll see, Clementine.
What's this thing?
Daddy said it's called a salt lick.
Yeah, but don't lick it. It's gross.
Did you lick it?
I don't know.
Funny.
How do you like that cow, Clint?
She's pretty.
And very pregnant.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
How's the cow?
Well, better now we got Doc on the case.
When do you think, we might eat?
Hungry, huh? Don't worry. Mama's cooking up some good grub.
This dude gets excited every time for food. Like, my eyes just open wide.
Have I missed anything?
No, not really. It smells funny in here.
Like duty.
Kids.
She looks skinny.
And now to talk about the hat.
Here, Clementine.
My hat! You found it! I knew you'd find it. You said you would.
Listen, did you give your hat to anyone?
No.
Did you see any strangers around the motor inn who might have taken it?
No. Why?
It's probably nothing. Just let me know if you ever see anything like that.
Okay, I will. Hey, Lee, do you think you'll ever have kids?
I don't know. I haven't thought about having kids in a long time.
Well, Thanks for finding my hat.
You're welcome, Clem.
I thought she was about to be like, well, if you need anybody, I'm here. I would be like, that's just wrong, man. That's just wrong. And now to talk about this woman we found in the woods.
We met this woman up in the woods. She seemed to know your brother.
He probably talks a little more than he oughta.
Thanks. Yep.
Clearly, they're trying to hide something. Yeah, that was extremely pointless. Let's check out what else is in this barn. More of nothing. I probably shouldn't, but hey, you never know. Third time be the charm. And of course, third time is the charm. Or not. I know when we find some batteries for that camera, we might find something they don't want us to know.
You found it too, huh? Lee, they're hiding something behind this door. I got a quick look. They got boxes of stuff and something metal and sharp.
Don't get paranoid.
It's my job to be paranoid, Lee. I got my whole family on this farm right now. How about you? What about Clem?
I'll protect her no matter what.
I know you will. Look, that guy with Katya, what's his name? He locked it up real tight the second we came in. I definitely heard a noise back there, Lee.
What?
My point is, we gotta know for sure. So go find a hammer or something, and I'll have this thing off in a second. You back me up in case them farmers come running.
Hang on, man. Think this through. You smash the lock. Then what if it turns out you're wrong? You just fucked your chance to get a good meal in those kids you're trying to protect. Use your head, Kenny.
All right, Professor. What'd you have in mind?
Let me have a look at what we're dealing with first.
Hey, Lee. You know how to pick a lock, right?
No. Why would you say that?
Well, you're, you know, urban.
Wow.
You are not saying what I
think. Oh, wow.
Jesus, man, I'm from Florida. Crazy shit just comes out of my mouth sometimes. Sorry. What?
You're urban.
Screws? Instead of breaking the padlock, we can just take off the assembly. Have a peek inside and then replace it all again like nothing ever happened.
All right, sounds like you got a plan. I'll hang around and keep an eye on that guy with the cow.
Andy.
Shit, I thought that was Danny. Whatever.
Can I help you boys find something?
You just ask him.
What's behind this door, Andy?
Just tools. We keep it locked so the people in the woods don't try and grab them. We'd be dead without them. Hey, do me a favor. Don't fuck around with this door, okay? Just, you know, Mama gets nervous.
Andrew, I need your help again.
No problem. Right away, Doc.
So, we got his answer, and if that's not how it truly is, then we know he's lying for sure. Instead of just feeding around a bush. Distract Annie to get him out of the barn.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
Why do you lock that door?
Because we can't afford to lose our shit to the people in the woods. They come down here every once in a while to raid our stuff, even with the fence.
I wonder if I was just straight up asking for a screwdriver, but I don't know.
Danny mentioned he needed something.
Did he say what?
Shit, I can't remember now. Sorry.
All right. Be right back, Doc.
Now we gotta find a screwdriver ASAP.
Okay, let's do this.
False alarm. I'm back.
You serious?
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
You got a screwdriver?
For what?
Never mind.
Well, there that goes. Probably shouldn't have asked
all right,
that.
All right. Be right back, Doc.
I don't know about this guy here.
Okay, let's do this.
False alarm. I'm back.
All right, clearly I'm doing something wrong. Maybe I can go back in there later and try to figure out, you know, everything that's going on.
So, how does a woman like yourself run this whole place?
Oh, gosh. Here comes the love connection.
I couldn't do it without it.
So we need to find a screwdriver amongst other things.
What's going on, Lee? Did something happen?
There may be something going on with that barn.
I'm telling you, Lee, the longer we stay here, the more trouble we're getting ourselves into.
And what exactly do you think I'm supposed to do about it?
If you want to go in there and start rooting through other people's shit, then get to it. But if it's up to me, we should just take our food and go.
What were you and Kenny arguing about when I came back from the camp?
He's losing it, Lee. He comes over and starts talking about searching the barn and that these people are hiding something. The way I see it, we just need to skip the dinner and get our food to go. But I'm starting to think your friend over there has another agenda.
After what Kenny told me, I'm starting to think they may be trying to hide something.
You two are just asking for trouble. But if you insist on wandering around, I'd be careful, Lee.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Watch yourself, Lee.
I mean, clearly they're hiding something at this point. I think we all know that for sure. And as soon as we find batteries for this camera, maybe that can help shed some light amongst things. But actually, let's see if we can plug it into the wall. I forgot there was an outlet. So maybe that might work in some kind of way. Maybe not.
Yeah. Doesn't look very safe, but I guess that's the point.
All right, maybe not. Generator. Probably shouldn't
switch.
There's no reason for me to do it, so I'm not. Oh well, this will be where the screwdriver is, at least I hope so.
It's a small toolbox.
No duh.
Just gonna borrow this for a second.
Coolio. Take a look at I guess take a minor business. I have no care whatsoever about those two characters. Hopefully this multi-tool includes a screwdriver, otherwise probably still doesn't help. Actually, you know what, I do need batteries for this damn thing, so yeah, let me go ask them. Maybe we can find out some stuff. La-di-da-di. Now time to cock block.
We'll finish talking later.
Cock blocker.
You been getting along with Larry?
He's just a big old sweetheart, ain't he?
Don't know if I would have used those words exactly.
Don't judge, honey. This world is bringing out the worst in people. But if you really look, you'll catch a glimpse of humanity every now and then.
How's Mark doing in there?
Best patient I ever had. Oh, my boys get so much as a scratch and start hollering. He could definitely teach them a thing or two about being tough.
I'd still like to check on him.
You're gonna have to trust me on this, Lee. I've helped stitch my share of wounds. I know what I'm talking about.
Now I can ask her about the trouble, or I can ask her about the barn. I probably best not to ask about the barn, but you know, if we just want to get too straight to the answer, why not be straight and forward, you know?
Those bandits just don't know when to quit. But my boys, they can hold their own.
Why did you make a deal with those people?
We got a thread of humanity left, Lee. We can do more good without them in our hair by placating them. So that's what we do.
Yeah, I'll just leave it at that. I really don't know. But I'm about to just be like, you know, fuck it.
So, what are y'all keeping the barn back there? Besides cows, I mean.
Well, someone's getting a little curious, aren't they?
I don't mean to pry.
It's nothing interesting, I can promise you that much. Just some odds and ends. Takes a lot to run a farm, you know.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Kinda peaceful out here, ain't it? Enjoy it while you can. You'll probably start hearing those monsters frying against the fence before too long.
Alright, so now we have her answer and we have the other guy's answer. Both seem to obviously keep feeding around the bush. They're not being straightforward at all, so our only goal now is to get up in that Actually, hold on. Let me check that generator. Maybe that was an indicator for something, because it might be off and they don't even know it. Actually, it's on, so yeah, I'm not gonna touch it. Just leave it be. And now let's try to check out what's in this barn. Hey, your brother's calling you for the third time.
So, where do you keep the rest of the tools?
Well, if you need something, just tell me what it is, and I can get it for you.
Not that important.
Alrighty then. Hey guys, seriously, don't fuck around with that. Come on, enough already.
He ain't playing no games.
I picked up something I think could help with the lock.
All right, good to hear.
I tried distracting Andy, but he keeps coming back.
There's got to be something out there you can mess with to keep him busy for a while. What about those generators?
Okay, maybe that's why we could kind of mess with it. But that might be a bad thing. Just because we want to be nosy, we might possibly fuck up the generator. And as the walkers are coming, the time he's trying to probably going to have to repair the generator, they're going to slip in and everybody dies. And whole time, there's nothing behind the barn. So that's how I'm probably thinking this is how it's going to go. Hopefully not, because if I trust this guy and he turns out to be wrong, and this is one of those decisions where it's like, oh man, fuck. Fuck. Wasn't me. I didn't do it. I didn't do it. Oh, it looks like I can cut some, actually.
Damn, this thing is the worst piece of shit. Something's always tripping the breaker.
look at the old guy. I forgot his name already. He's just sitting there in the corner, just watching everything. He's like, I saw that. Wow. So the fact that I actually have to cut something, this is not going to be good, because now I'm really messing it up. And as those walkers start to come in, it's not going to be a lot to do. Besides, hold on, wait, where did it go? I don't even see the cut option anymore. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Not a good idea at all.
There you go. Looks like that belt's driving the, whatchamacallit?
Yes, the, whatchamacallit confibrillator. Right.
thing is, I'm too tight for my bare hands.
See, man, this is like, why would we even do this? This makes no point. It makes no sense at this point.
There, that should do it.
Fucking Danny, where'd he find this piece of shit? Oh, fucking thing threw a belt. Damn it, dog. Ah, oh, son of a fuck.
I use this opportunity to check out what's behind the barn. Hopefully that's something he can fix, and I have to worry about being overrated with walkers as they come in at night. And everything is good, you know what I mean? We'll do this quick, bow, boom. He won't even know. And everybody's cool.
Dinner time! It's dinner time!
Okay, honey, let's get that.
Dad! Dad! Come on! Let's eat!
Kenny, come along, honey. Kenny, come on. Don't make the children wait.
I'll make an excuse for you. Get that thing off.
Of course, it's not even my idea yet. I'm the one who has to do it, and I'm the one who's probably going to get caught. There's all sorts of terrible things that can go wrong with this right now, but, Of course, I don't have a choice. So I'm just Mr. Nice. Mr. Nice. And screwing the screws. Causing havoc. He ain't even bothered to like put the things in his pockets. He could have just took a peek. What is it? What is it? What is it? Holy, what? Oh, nah, cuz.
Boy, didn't you hear the bell? Dinner time.
Uh-oh.
What the hell you got in that back room?
Look, we have food here, but Danny and I still gotta do a lot of hunting to keep everyone fed. When we catch something in the woods, we skin it and dress it back there. Mama doesn't like us to make a mess in the house. So you see,
they eat in humans. That sounds reasonable, but I don't know. Just like that. Dun dun dun. The suspense is killing me.
Oh, Brenda, you are an angel.
Excuse the mess. We had to block the back door after a walker got upstairs. Don't worry. That was a while ago and ain't been back inside since.
Everybody sit down. Now go get the meal. Oh, this is a delight.
I could eat a horse.
Where's Mark?
Now don't you worry about him. I've already brought some food up. You just let him rest.
Oh, I know how this is going. They're eating people, son. We're about to eat Mark. Oh, nah. These people are carnivores or herbivores or whatever the freaking term is. They eat people. Man, this is trifling, man. Oh, my God. This game is awesome.
Baseball trophy. Seems like it's been years since kids were playing sports for fun.
But yeah, let's see how this unfolds.
Hysteria must have meant a lot to them before the walkers destroyed everything.
Because they talking about, son, they got plenty of food and whatnot. Obviously, there's only a couple certain ways. Maybe they ate their husband, too.
This must be Terry.
Looking like the colonel from KFC. What we got in here?
Gauze pads. Looks old. Label's worn off. I could use a shave. Some kind of lotion.
Some kind of lotion. Oh man, oh man. So what am I doing here? Oh, you were investigating. I have a feeling he's not up here. In fact, Mark is dead. Mark is in more than one ways on tonight's dinner table. We're just having some apple pie and a side of Mark. You know all these stupid punchline puns I can make. Alright, so we got a bedroom door. And we got a closet door. Let's check out what's going on with this closet. We got morphine.
Too much morphine for.
To knock people out while they're killing them.
Smart.
We learned what happens with morphine in L.A. Noir.
I guess someone needed some first aid recently. Ugh, what is this stuff? Looks like a bunch of medical waste in here. IV tubes, saline. What would dairy farmers need with this kind of stuff?
They're not dairy farmers!
What the hell?
So now things are really getting, kind of weird.
Ugh, what is this stuff? Looks like a bunch of medical waste in here. IV tubes, saline. What would dairy farmers need with this kind of stuff?
Something's going on, and we're going to figure it out. My heart is really pumping because I'm just dying to see, no pun intended. All right, so there's no one in the bed. I guess first off, let's look at the bed.
It was Mark. But Brenda said he was up here resting.
Maybe he's in the pot cooking downstairs. Got a bookshelf. We got some stains.
Is that blood? Farm books, cookbooks, nothing out of the ordinary here.
Except the light coming behind it. Man, this is just going bad, man. At this point in time, we definitely need to get the hell out of here. Don't eat it.
Don't eat that!
What?
Huh?
Lee, Jesus, man. Did you find something? Oh, sit your ass down, Lee. This lady has made you a meal.
Yeah, Lee. What's gotten into you?
He just had a start.
He could use some goddamn manners.
It didn't have to be this way.
You're eating human meat!
That's crazy.
What the hell? You're scaring the kids, Lee.
Lee, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't indulge him, Lily. It's always something with this guy.
Uh-oh.
Mom, I was eating that.
What is going on?
We need to get the kids and everyone out of here. We need to go now.
Everything could have turned out okay for you folks.
He would have died anyway. We gotta think about living.
Settle down, honey. Growing up in rural Georgia, you're taught not to waste. It's how I was raised and how I raised my boys. Now, you got monsters roaming around that do nothing but eat people. And for what? To continue to rot till they eat some more. We think we can put that meat to better use.
Oh, I'm gonna puke.
Just let us go.
Andy is right. We go after folks who were gonna die anyways, one way or another.
Like y'all.
Clementine, run!
Nobody's going anywhere.
We got lots of use for y'all right here.
Oh, what? Wow.
The fucking what?
Put your guns down! We're walking out of here!
Mommy,
family.
I don't want to die. Mommy, what did I eat?
Everyone, everything will be okay.
Lee? Lee?
I don't know what to do. Osh. Osh.
Let go of her, you son of a bitch!
The hell was that? What is going on in here?
Please. Someone.
Come
on. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Whoa.
Open wow. The goddamn door! You can't keep us in here! Open up! I will tear you fuckers apart with my bare hands!
We gotta find another way out of here!
You damn fucking bastards! Open this door, goddammit!
So where did you find barbecue meat?
It was a person. They tried to make us eat a person.
But you didn't do it.
No.
The rest of us did, goddammit! If you hadn't dragged your feet!
Come on, Dad. Now's not the time.
You okay, Clementine? They didn't hurt you, did they?
Mm-mm.
Open up!
Lee, those psychos have my family, and we're stuck in a damn meat locker! We gotta get the fuck out of here!
This goddamn thumbsucker was the one who brought us here!
Will you all just shut the fuck up?
I'm scared.
Don't be. It's gonna be okay. I'm gonna find us a way out of here.
You're worse than the walkers!
Dad, please!
Oh, man. So, shit's getting real. We don't even have to worry about walkers anymore. We got people eating people.
Think we can heave it through the door?
Nah, door's too solid.
Please settle down!
I'll rip your goddamn heads off!
Come on, Larry. Do you really want to attract their attention?
Yeah, I want to attract their attention. So I can fucking kill him!
Guess your new girlfriend wasn't all she was cracked up to be.
What the hell is your problem? You were a prick back at the motor lodge, and you went out of your way to be an asshole to me tonight. You must really hate me. But guess what? You're stuck with me. I plan to be around long after you're gone. And if you turn, I'll be the one to put the axe through your skull.
Dad!
Open up, goddammit!
I'm not your enemy, Larry.
I don't believe you. Don't forget, I know who you really are.
Come on, try yourself!
It just won't end with that guy.
Easier for us.
Open the fucking
Dad,
door!
Dad, stop!
Goddammit! There's more of us on the way!
Okay.
Let us out now!
Let's see what else we got.
That's not gonna
help! They got Katya and Duck, Lee! Those fuckers have my family!
I know!
He over here looking like here for some secret button you can push. Right, good luck with that.
You think I'm fucking up? I'll break that damn door down!
Dad, you can't get...
Oh, gosh, I knew that was gonna happen.
Easy!
Oh, God.
Dad? No! Dad, come on! Dad! Oh, God. He stopped breathing. I think he's had a heart attack.
Shit. Is he dead?
He's not dead. Somebody help me.
Fuck. If he's dead...
He's not dead.
What has to happen, Lee? Think about it. You saw that poor bastard at the motel? How fast he turned?
What are you saying?
Don't make me choose.
I'm sorry. I truly am.
Don't make me choose.
In a few minutes, we're gonna be stuck in a locked room with a 6'4", 300-pound, seriously pissed off dead guy.
Fuck you! We can bring him back! Lee!
We'll mourn him later. But right now, we have to keep him from coming back.
No!
Either hit him with
God
the block,
damn it, Kenny.
Or find a way out
dead.
Quick.
can't kill him if he's not dead, Kenny.
Remember how hard it was for you to get that monster off of Katya? And Larry's twice his size. It's him or us.
Look, Kenny, back at the drugstore when we all thought Duck was bitten, I gave him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe we should do the same now.
That was different. Duck wasn't bitten. Come on! We know this guy's not gonna make it. Remember what Ben said. Gotta destroy the brain. Come on,
Don't
Lee.
Make me do
you
it. Don't make me do it.
You gotta have my back this time.
God damn it, Lee! I need you! Please help me! Come on, Dad.
Oh, man.
Come on.
Don't.
Wake up.
Make me.
Wake up.
Do it.
Ah.
Is he breathing at all?
No. No, I don't think so.
Okay, let me take over. Keep checking his pulse.
Oh,
are you
gonna
stupid?
Do it anyway.
He's gonna turn! You're putting all of us at risk, you son of a bitch!
Two,
you're fucking worthless, Lee.
Oh.
No!
Wow.
Kenny, what the fuck?
I'm so sorry. I just...
It had to be done.
You don't know that!
Yes, I do, Lee. And so do you. I was counting on you, man.
Wow.
I'm sorry. I know.
Don't you fucking touch me!
Are you okay?
Aren't you just crying?
Is it over?
Yes, for now. But we still need to find a way out of here.
I know. But you gotta be strong right now. I need you to be strong. Think about something else, something hopeful.
Like what?
How about your walkie-talkie? Those pretend talks with your mom and dad, don't those make you feel better?
Sometimes. We're gonna get out, right? You found a way out?
I'm working on it.
Wow. Yeah. He dead. He definitely dead now.
I'm sorry, Lily.
He was still alive, Lee. He was still alive.
Jenny, we made a bad call. It was premature for sure, but he was trying to keep us safe.
Bullshit. He cares about keeping his family safe. He doesn't give a shit about you and me.
He puts his family first, sure. Just like Larry did.
I know it was necessary, but I just wish Clem didn't have to witness shit like this. I worry what it's gonna do to her.
Gonna turn her into a ruthless killing child. Now let's talk to this guy who probably hates me.
I don't want to hear it, Lee. You think I like doing what I did? I'm the guy who couldn't bear to watch the family dog get put down. But if we want to survive this shit, we gotta have the balls to do the hard thing. Or at least one of us has got to.
Look, if we're gonna survive this shit, we got to work together. How do you expect Lily to work with us after what she just saw you do?
If she wants to live, she'll work with us. If she doesn't, then the hell with her.
Oh, man. Emotions are high.
There ought to be an air duct behind this unit. Maybe big enough for one of us to fit through.
Does the air conditioner come off?
I think I could take it off if I had something to remove the screws. The multi-tool. Of course they took it. Shit.
Maybe there's something else we could use. I've got a rock.
I'm about to be like, if they didn't take it, wow.
Coin might do the trick. Do you have a coin? If we can remove these screws, the AC should come down easily. It's not coming off that way.
Alright, let's see what we can find.
Listen, I need a coin or something. It's important. It could get us out of here.
Well, I got nothing.
Please. I need to be alone.
God knows you deserve time to grieve, Lily. But if we're gonna get out of here, we need your help. And Larry's. I think I may have found a way out of here, but I need something to remove the screws on the air conditioner. If you had something I could use as a screwdriver, a coin or something.
No.
What about him? Look, I know this is a terrible time for it, but back at the motor inn, Larry mentioned something about keeping coins in his pockets.
What do you want? My blessing to loot his corpse?
Your permission.
Do what you have to do.
Ain't got it to me twice. I'm taking everything. Ain't boy. No more nice.
Any idea which pocket he keeps his change in?
That thing must be heavy. Because, wow. Straight annihilated that guy's head. We got a pocket, and we got another pocket.
Here we go. Two quarters and a dime.
That's 60 cent. Or as they like to say around my way, two quarters and a dime.
Hurry the fuck up, Lee. We don't have all day here.
Somebody else about to get knocked out if you don't shut up. Georgia.
Well, here's our way out, Lee.
We don't know where it leads.
Looks like it'll probably lead right into that back room.
I can find out.
You think you can do this?
I'm scared.
It's okay to be scared.
We need you, Clementine.
Okay.
You're gonna be fine.
What do I do when I get out?
See if you can get to the other side of that door and open it.
We wait for Samuela Fisher in Splinter Cell, Walking Dead.
Are you okay? Did anyone see you?
No, but there's a man outside.
Where the hell are you going?
What do you care?
Kenny! Lily, I'm sorry. We gotta go.
I know. I just need a minute to say goodbye. Hey, we're good. Okay?
Yeah, this is good.
Shit, he's gonna get us all killed. Stay here. Take care of Lily, okay?
I will.
Let's see what's going on now. We got two guys to kill and one deranged old woman.
I told you there was something up with this room. It's a goddamn human slaughterhouse.
Let's see if anything, and hopefully we have a few things that we can use. A hay hook. Yeah, that'll be deadly. And his pockets is just like, he's got like the capsule corpse pocket. He could fit anything inside of a little pocket. Brains. That's just sick.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
I know.
Ooh. God, what's wrong with these people? Maybe I shouldn't have sent Clementine through there. This room would give anybody nightmares.
Well, too late to be thinking about that kind of stuff now. Batteries? Ooh, a taser. Hell yeah. More things that fit in the magical pocket. Oh, I can only choose one? A taser or a hay hook? I think a taser might be more useful. Might be able to knock out somebody, but wow, the fact that they're making me choose now.
What's wrong with these people? Jesus, this is where they butcher people.
Sick bastards. All of them.
But it sounds like this definitely wants to be some kind of stealth mission, and I'm guessing anything else, I'm going to have to repeatedly stab. But a taser, you know, if you get him good, he should be able to, you know, get knocked out.
What the hell do you think you're doing? Getting my family back. What are you going to do? Walk up and grab his gun? Good a plan as any.
And now we follow the idiot.
It ain't right making me stay out here all night. I didn't know them. They just treat me like some kind of school.
Dun, 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 dun.
Hey, what are you doing outside the bar?
Oh, shit.
Just going to the place.
The fact that we said that at the same time.
Well, keep sitting out in the rain like a damn deer. Mama says we can't keep that many folks alive and not expect trouble. Take one to keep and kill the rest. Not the kid. There's enough meat on the tray.
Oh, I know, Mabel. This is my favorite too. When I let one think they can just walk right out, they never even look down.
I ask a will. Gonna have to do this good.
Where is he? Tell me what's going on.
I don't see him anymore.
Where the fuck did he go?
I don't know.
Look again. He didn't go past us.
I'll keep an eye on him. Be ready to act when I say.
See what he's doing now.
I don't like this. Oh, shit. What? Grr. I knew that was going to happen. I knew that was fucking going to happen. Really? The taser didn't work? That little bitch didn't even try to do nothing. Now you see who your real friends are. Where your real friends at? Fuck a fake friend, where your real friends at?
No!
You don't like to do too much explaining. So asshole here. I wouldn't even care at that point. He's a murderer. He ain't help nobody. I got shot, came back to life.
You see? You understand now, don't you? You can have me. It's how the world works now. Give part of yourself so others can live.
I should fucking kill you right now.
Cannibalism is not the answer. Aren't the walkers eating enough of us?
You gotta keep me alive. If you kill me, the meat gets tainted. You can't eat it.
You're already tainted.
You ain't gonna kill me. Just like you didn't kill Jolene. You don't have what it takes. Fucking coward.
It ain't worth it, you know what I mean? People might be watching.
This is not how the world works now. You won't make me kill you.
It ain't worth it. Be the bigger man, you know what I mean? He's already in a tough position. See? Clementine was watching. Now imagine if she would have seen me kill that guy. Cold-blooded, you know? I feel like a true hero right now. Even though that other guy was a pure bitch.
Just stay here and keep Clementine safe.
I'll be right back.
Started from the barn, now we here. Started from the barn, now my whole team here now.
Kenny!
It's the game thing, it's a lightning storm. They probably didn't hear the gunshot, but yeah, I wonder what's going on. They got his wife and his son. Hopefully they haven't started eating them already or nothing like that, but who knows? It's hard to tell. As we're rolling. We're going to eat some crab. I'm sorry, crabs. Oh, man, I've been wanting crabs for the longest. What we're going to do, eat some corn? Uh-oh. We got walkers. Wait, who the hell did that? Oh, wow. Where was she at all this time?
Lee?
Ow!
Shh! Is everyone okay? You guys have been gone way too long.
They attacked us!
I knew it. I told you we couldn't trust them.
Shit! How many of them are there?
Two left.
Where?
Larry's dead. They chopped off Mark's legs and tried to feed them to us.
Shit! Is everyone else okay?
They've still got Duck and Kaja in the house, and I don't know where the fuck Kenny is.
All right, we're coming in to help.
The main gate is too dangerous. Go around the fence and see if there's a back way in. I'll keep looking for Kenny. Do you have a weapon?
I don't leave home without it. Ben, stick close. And Lee, be careful.
Hey, I totally forgot about those two. But it's kind of good because I'm making my survivors who I want them to be. Let's go save some people.
Oh, I'm going to take the boy and check around.
No, please don't take my boy.
Let go, woman.
Settle down. I don't want to hurt y'all.
Andy? Danny, is that you? What's going on out there?
I left Danny in the bar. He got what he deserved.
Come here. Let me go.
Oh, I said the wrong thing.
Lee, get back. Don't come in here. You just had to go snooping around, didn't you?
Let her go, Brenda.
What can I do?
Now you know you don't want to do this.
Just go away and leave us be.
There's got to be something I can use around here.
Stop right there! I mean it.
You got it. You got it. I'm not coming up any closer. Put the gun down, bitch.
Watch your husband.
That's what I want to say.
He had wanted his dairy turned into a slaughterhouse.
I'll kill her, Lee.
Okay, I'm a back her up close enough to where the zombie on that. You see him right above there? Yeah, I think that's what's gonna happen. I just gotta keep sweet talking her. You got it. You got it. I just need you to back you up a little bit more. This is going good.
Let her go, Brenda.
Please listen to him.
Please. I don't want to kill you, Lee.
Don't kill me then.
This dairy was your pride. Look what you've done to it.
Just a little bit more. A little bit more. Almost there, baby. I should be a police negotiator.
Help! Ah! Ah! They took Doug! Where's Kenny?
I said,
get out the way!
Move, asshole! Don't you fucking hurt him!
Oh my god!
I would have took her gun at least.
That ain't gonna
Don't!
Shut up!
Wow.
Andy!
Now another hostage situation.
Thank you all. Look at what you've done!
Calm down.
Calm down? What for? All we wanted was some goddamn gasoline!
Yeah, let's do it. Fight to the end, little biatch. They must have knew I was going to say biatch. That's why they said, you know, hit B. Psychic. And of course, nobody still wants to help.
Get up. Get the fuck up.
No, I refuse to die by electricity. Soulja Boy is not a real rapper. Detox will never release, because Dr. Dre said so. Alright, really, how long do I got to keep tapping this? I'm just really, really wondering now at this point. Like, come on. Really, is this a glitch? I don't. Do I have to let him do it or something? I don't understand at this point. Can someone explain? Not on.
Lily.
And there we go. You mother sucker! I'm gonna kill you. Oh wait. You can't do that. It's not fit. What the? Oh, I hope he doesn't ultimately like land on the gate by accident. Oh man. Talk about timing.
Is that all you got, Lee? You ain't shit.
Yet.
It's over!
9,000!
Fuck you! As soon as Dan and Mama get out here, you're all fucked! I said, it's over! Just walk away! Don't you dare walk away from me, Lee!
Being the bigger man, always.
Get back here and finish this, Lee!
Sounds just like Vegeta. But Goku is just way too strong in this episode. It's not worth it, man. You, my friend, are trash. Going home to my real family. Anytime it wants to load.
Get back here and fight me like a man, Lee.
Of course, the walkers are probably going to take care of him. So even though I was the bigger man, your generator, your defense, everything you set up, it's now over.
Lee.
Let's go.
All in all, we only lost one guy, I believe. One that was a real asshole, and it's not bad at all, you know? I think this was a great episode. Decisions were made. Tough decisions were, you know, carried out. But I did it. I am that guy.
Hey, Lee. I'd say I'm sorry for leaving the motel unattended, but, you know.
I'm glad you showed up when you did. If you hadn't taken that shot at Andy, we might not have gotten out of there.
Were they really killing people? For food?
Nah, we just made that up.
Yeah, they were.
That is sick. God, just... ugh. Clementine, she doesn't know, right?
She's not stupid, Carly.
Katja managed to grab this while she was in the house. She said it was with your stuff.
Yeah. I found it while I was looking for the people who shot Mark. Do you want it?
Why don't you keep it? Sometimes it helps to have something you can document your thoughts on.
How are you doing?
I'll be fine. Just not as young as I used to be.
Wait, didn't he get shot?
Hon, go on ahead and give me and Lee a second. There's gonna be fallout.
For killing Lily's dad? Yeah, I would imagine so.
What do you think?
You murdered Larry.
Fuck you, man. You're alive because of me. Why didn't you have my back?
I saved your wife and kid.
No, I saved them. By making sure Larry didn't kill us.
Fuck this guy, man. Fuck this guy, man. He's too much, man.
Well, maybe we should stay out of each other's way for a while.
Hey, three less mouths to feed? I don't care. I just
come
don't.
On, Clementine. Stay close.
Lee, are those bad people dead?
We didn't kill them, so I don't know. They might have been able to get away from the walkers, but I'm sure they won't be coming after us.
That's good.
Hey, Dad, what's that noise?
Uh-oh.
Sounds like a car. Oh, God, not more strangers.
Come out or I'll shoot.
You know, you always gotta scare your opponent. Obviously, somebody was here. Actually, having a gun to back up that claim might be helpful.
Figures.
Oh, crap. Baby, you gotta see this. It's a shitload of food and supplies back here.
The jackpot. Things turned out pretty well for the surviving crew, after all.
This food could save all of us. Not all of us.
Look, we don't know if these people are dead.
If they come back, then we're just monsters who came out of the woods and ruined their lives.
This stuff isn't ours. Dad, whose car is it?
Don't worry about that, Duck. It's ours now.
It's abandoned, Ducky. Don't worry.
What if it's not? What if it's not abandoned? What if it is someone's?
Damn. We have to. Screw that, man. Hard knock life.
You're right. We shouldn't take this.
What? Did you get some meal back there the rest of us missed out on? We have to take this stuff.
Wait, I think I hit the wrong button. I wanted to take the food. No.
You're on a real tear today, huh?
What do you mean by that?
Come on, Kenny. Between this and the meat locker, you know what it means.
Fine. Suit yourself. The rest of us are taking this stuff. Okay, what have we got in here?
Look, there's more food in that box.
They have antibiotics. What else do they have?
See if there's any water.
Here. Got it?
Yeah, I got it.
Lee, there's a hoodie in here. Could probably fit Clementine.
She's good. Thanks.
Whatever, man. It's gonna get cold out eventually.
Hey, there were some batteries in one of those boxes. I thought they might work in your camcorder. Here, you can have some too. For your walkie-talkie.
Batteries, huh? Think you can handle those?
You're not gonna let me live that down, are you? Oh, God. Lee, you're gonna wanna see this.
Wonder what's on the camera. Oh wow, they've been watching them.
They call y'all bandits, but you're fucking rapers,
Oh, darling baby, look at you. Look at you. You need a mama, sweetheart. We won't let them bandits get you, will we?
How you doing, Clementine?
No. Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If
y'all
I find
thinking
it,
you're
I'll
safe?
Let you know.
Sitting there acting like things are the way they used to be. The dead don't kill their own.
It's the living you gotta be afraid of. The people I used to call friends. The people who took... Don't worry, little girl. Bandits got their eye on that dairy. As long as they keep getting food from them, you'll be safe. I promise.
This is so weird, son. Is that her mother? I don't even know at this point. She's totally something else. Or just a nut.
This place is done. It's time to move on. Screw it. Not like you ever listened to a damned word I say.
Is this all you got?
I told you this town is tapped. Do you have any idea what we had to do to get all that? We need to leave.
Duck was asking about the farm last night. Not much phases away, but it's starting to add up. I need to get to the coast. Get him out of all this madness.
Damn.
He's not doing so good, huh?
You murdered her dad.
I did what I had to, and you know it. Maybe people out there got things lined up better. Better than us, at least. Could be folks who have all this shit figured out.
People get mad when they're scared?
Sometimes, yeah, they do.
This is crazy! I'm the one keeping this group going!
We can sort this all out, all right? We can sort this out!
I'll tell you what we need to sort out. We can't let one person fuck this up for everyone else!
Wow. Thanks for watching. Comment and, of course, subscribe. Please remember to like the video. And, yeah, that's been episode 2. Brought to you by Michael. Hope you enjoyed it. Let's see, 84% of players chopped off his leg. I don't think we had a choice. 80% of players listened to her before Danny shot her. Tried to save him. Didn't kill the brothers. chose not to take supplies. So there's a lot of, you know, greedy people out there. That's what these stats are telling us. But yeah, catch you all later. Promise not to take 4 months for the next part. If anything, I'm gonna try to go ahead, jump right into that tomorrow. So yep, catch you all later.